So I've been called out today to find a fault on a gas boiler. The particular model of this gas boiler, I think it's a British Gas 330. The heating system is a Y-plan heating system. So you've just controlling hot water and central heating. So everything is all working absolutely fine, but it's not working now. So that's why I've been called out. Apparently someone has been out to look at it, but they wasn't really too sure. So I'm just here looking at it now and just hopefully seeing what I can find. I haven't fixed the fault. I have done a few fault finding procedures and just checking that the system is operating. And so I just wanted to run through a couple of things that I have done. And there might be more things that I'm missing. If there is anything else, you might be able to pick it up or comment on the video. But this is what I've done so far. So basically, we've got the programmer here. Through into the kitchen over there, you've got the water tank, the hot water tank. Up in the loft space above, all the controls, the three-port valve, etc. You've got a thermostat here. It's just a basic Y-plan system, to be fair. Okay, so you've got your 3-amp fuse connection unit here. We turn this on, as you can see, the programmer lights up. Now this 3-amp fuse spur, it's not on its own circuit, it's off the ring circuit in the house. As you can see, there's power to this. So I've undone this box here, and behind here you've got a load of terminations, and so you've got the two lots of cables here that are going up to the main wiring center up in the loft. I'm not gonna go up there. I've already checked it all out in there. It's all absolutely fine. The problem is here at the boiler. So that's why we're just gonna focus on this at the moment. So I just went on the internet, typed it up, the instruction manual for it was the first thing that came up. So I was able to read through it and just sort of get to where I am at the moment. So we've got power here. If you look underneath, you've got this flexible cable here that comes from one of the junction boxes in here. And from in that junction box, you've got a main supply, you've got a switch live, and then you've got your neutral and your earth wire. And so then if we just follow it round here, you can't quite see it too easily in there. But in there we have got, yeah, so you've got your mains live, you've got a switch live, the neutral, you have the pump neutral and the pump live. So basically what that's telling me is that this boiler requires a permanent live feed, and it also has a switch live feed operated from the three-port valve when it needs to be used. Once this is then fired up from the three-port valve, then it engages the water pump as well. Where I'm at the moment is in the, as you can see on the front of the screen, there's no display whatsoever on the front of the screen. On the instructions, it basically, there's a sort of a fault finding procedure to follow. And the first thing it says, is there a display on the front? Yes, go down this route. No, go down this route. So obviously it says no, and basically all it says, just check the wiring. Is there a mains live supply going to the boiler? As you can see, the live is on, and this one here is the one on the far left is the live. So I'm just going to probe onto this, and as you can see, that's indicating that the far left one, which is the mains live, is live. Obviously we've got this control board here. Looks quite complicated, lots of connections. So then I need to follow that live through into here, and that comes through into this white cable here. But the trouble is the white cable then goes underneath, it comes out and it comes down, oh here we are, yeah. It comes down to these two wires here, the live and neutral. So again, probe onto these ones, and the other side of this is just the switch, like the on off switch. What I've done, you've got the live and the neutral coming through into this side. I'm not going to do it on camera because it's just a bit hard holding the connections and the test at the same time and filming it. But basically you've got your live and neutral here. This is a reset switch or an on off switch. And so again, I've tested that there's live and neutral there. Like I said, it's no good just testing that it's live, because it could be the neutral that's at fault. So I've tested the live and neutral here. I've then tested the live and neutral coming out of there, which is all okay. And then if we trace these wires back, these two red and white wires, that then brings us to here. And as you can see, there is a fuse on that one. Now looking at the fuse, it all looks okay. But this is basically where I'm at. I've tested to see that the live and neutral is live and neutral here. So I've turned it off, disconnected this, probed my probes into the holes, tested it, and it's absolutely fine. I probe onto the fuse and nothing comes up. I'll just turn it all off and just disconnect this fuse. I've just dropped it on the floor. I then turn it back on and then probe there and it's working. I'm not quite sure what it is, so it might be completely irrelevant. It might be something that's causing the problem. I just don't know without looking further into it. The fuse itself is absolutely fine. Basically, this is where I'm up to. I think really what they need to do is call out a boiler engineer. I've done the bits as far as I can do with regards to the electrical system. Everything is working. Every time we operate the hot water, the heating, the correct and relevant terminations in here become live, but the boiler's just not working. There might be a simple reset button. I just can't find it, not really sure, but at least I have done my electrical side is okay. And so really, I'm gonna have to tell the customer now, they're gonna have to call out a gas engineer to have a look at it. Apart from showing that the electrical supply to the boiler is okay, but as far as I'm concerned now, that's me done. If I find out what the problem was, I'll do another video and we'll go through it again to show what the problem was. But I'm suspecting maybe the board could be at fault. I'm not really sure.